Oil prices, meanwhile, are clawing back after Saudi Arabia approached fellow oil producers to discuss a market intervention. OPEC's largest oil producer is said to be considering all options to stem this decline. Ben Sharples of Bloomberg News reports on the options before Saudi Arabia and its allies.
The biggest tool that Saudi Arabia has is managing supply. But if you look at what's happening under that OPEC Plus agreement already, they're already cutting more than what they agreed to. So whether they have extra wriggle room to cut supply there is a big question. I mean, the details are a bit vague. They're talking about or using all options. They're talking about speaking to other producers. But we don't know who they are or what those options are at the moment. But as you saw by the price moves, when it is Saudi Arabia, it is the world's biggest crude exporter, so they still have a little bit of power when it comes to influencing the market. For oil and for many markets across the spectrum, you know, it's a demand-driven story. It's a lot to do about the US-China trade war, the uncertainties there, and you've seen the aggressive moves in the market. You do have Brent in a bear market. WTI has, over the past 3 days, has lost more than 8% due to these demand concerns. Is the lingering supply issues in the market with Venezuela, Iran, the sanctions there that are curbing supply. You also have simmering tensions in the Persian Gulf. But at the moment, it's overshadowing what's happening with demand. There are quite bearish scenarios out there if additional tariffs are put on, something like $20 to $30 a loss in the Brent price if there are additional tariffs. And we've got Bank of America even talking about crude supply demand falling by as much as 500,000 barrels a day. So the scenario and the sentiment in the market for oil and especially other asset classes is very bearish at the moment.